Hello, my name is Christa Michielsen. I'm a computational physicist. I work in Germany at the Jülich Supercomputing Center in the University of Aachen. On that day, I was working at the University of Antwerp in Belgium, and I was still living with my parents. But I was also preparing my move to Groningen in the north of the Netherlands, because I would start my PhD research there at January 1st. So somehow, I was also breaking a wall. As a child, I wanted to become a pilot, a company director, an engineer, and also an architect. All of my wishes came more or less true, but in one single profession. And this makes it even more exciting. My wish to become an architect came true in being closely involved in the planning of the building for UNIQ, the Jülich Unified Infrastructure for Quantum Computing. UNIQ provides researchers with an early entry into the practical applications of quantum computation. And in this building, UNIQ, we will house two different types of quantum computers. Then finally, as head of my research group, I can bring in my entrepreneurial and technical skills. My research is breaking the wall of practical quantum computing. With quantum computing, we face the beginning of a paradigm shift in computer science and scientific computing. The challenge is to develop prototype applications and use cases for this new type of computing. The first step towards a solution is to integrate quantum computers into the high-performance computing environment, which is a prerequisite for practical applications. A recent breakthrough in my research is quantum supremacy. Quantum supremacy marks the first moment when a quantum computer outperforms a conventional computer, and this for a specific problem. The demonstration of quantum supremacy marks a milestone in the paradigm shift of computing. And for the demonstration of quantum supremacy, we needed a large quantum processor, as large as possible, and also one with a low error rate. And at that moment, the candidate was Google's quantum processor Sycamore with 53 qubits. We also needed fast supercomputers, among which our own supercomputer Jules. And of course, we needed a problem. This problem had to be hard for conventional computers, but on the other hand, simple for quantum computers. Now, the chosen problem was a very theoretical one without any practical use. But I'm convinced that this milestone is a motivation for researchers to move to practical applications. Quantum computing promises unprecedented potential for hard computational problems such as quantum simulations, optimization, and machine learning. Now, optimization challenges comprise, among others, vehicle routing, power trading, supply chain network optimization, the optimization of radiation treatment of cancer, and also optimization of the target interactions for drug design. But optimization also lies at the heart of machine learning, artificial intelligence, computer vision, and data mining. So quantum computing can have a very large influence on science, industry, economy, but also on our everyday life. A quantum computer is a device that performs operations according to quantum theory. When the experiment cannot entirely be described by theory, then also many questions are popping up. So I can give you a few examples which I encounter in my research for the quantum flagship project Open SuperQ. There we have questions like, how do we model the real quantum computer? Can we simulate this model on a high-performance quantum computer? What are the deviations that we see between theory and experiment? Can we correct for them? What is the influence of these deviations on a quantum algorithm when this quantum algorithm runs on a real device? How do we translate real-world problems into a quantum algorithm? When will we have quantum computers that are big enough to solve these real-world problems? But for me, one big unanswered question is, when will we have a real quantum computer with which we can calculate problems that we cannot calculate with our conventional high-performance computers? Or maybe that we can solve when we use a combination of both, a quantum computer and a conventional computer integrated. They think it's unintelligible and very demanding, but also very fascinating and nowadays even fashionable, because all of the media attention that quantum computing currently gets.